Welcome to USU's Election Results Night 2024, broadcasting on University Radio York and YSTV. My name's Jess Rolfe.
And my name is Joe Brearley. As you may have seen around campus, candidates have been plastering the university with cardboard and paper to convince the students of the University of York that they're the right choice to represent them.
With 18,037 votes in the past 4 days, it's almost time to reveal who you chose as your seven new sabbatical officers for the 2024-25 academic year.
This past year has seen historic change for York Student Union, with the headline being the merger between the USU and the GSA. This change has meant that, for the first time, students in York will be represented by one body comprised of seven brand new sabbatical officer positions, championing the needs of both undergraduates and postgraduate students.
Our current SABs have been fighting for rent grants, scrapping with bus companies, and feeding students during stressful exam periods. Safe to say it's been a busy year here at York. We've had the merger, we won varsity against Durham again. What's been your favourite part so far, Joe?
I think it'd be suffice to say that the highlight of my year has been URY winning 4 student radio awards, including, unfortunately, Harvey Meller's gold SRA.
He's
looking
doing a
very
dance.
Happy.
He's very excited
for specialist music programming. But we had a great time down there in
we
London.
Did.
I'm not a London boy. I realised that.
No. You got lost on the tube.
I got lost on the tube. I ended up talking to a random woman outside of a what was the bookshop? A Waterstones, Waterstones bookshop.
You did.
Yeah, and you know what were you up to before Harvey's gold SRA, Jess?
So it was at the O2. I had my head in a bin. I wasn't very well, but great night all round.
Absolutely, and a successful night all round.
A successful night all round. My highlight: the full English breakfast the day after.
Absolutely.
Beautiful stuff.
So, if you tuned in to Election Results Night last year, then you may be getting deja vu here. You may remember me and Jess being on the big stage in Central Hall last year, where we somehow bumbled together a coherent broadcast and announced the SABs for 2023. I mean, clearly we did a decent job. We've been invited back for a sequel.
We have been demoted to backstage.
Yeah, but, you know.
That might be because last year we went to the wrong venue and got lost.
We did.
We were late.
We were a bit late. But we are very comfy here in the green room. I mean, these chairs are very nice.
They are very
comfortable. I think they have been stolen from the Costa that we are
really?
Currently in. nice one.
We're in a Costa. Yeah,
we're getting comfy. We're going to do some interviews with some sabbatical officers.
Yeah.
We're going to interview the winners, and we might have even get some previous sabbatical officers here in the green room. We're going to play some games. What games have we got coming up, Jess?
We've got a game about ducks. We've
Naturally.
Got a quiz about the Uni of York, because if you're going to be a sab here, you should know. We've got wrong answers only.
Yeah.
I can't remember. Guess that campaign slogan. We've got it all. We've got anything you could want.
If you want to do some revision for a guess that campaign slogan, you can find the evidence behind us here in the green room as we've kind of just nicked it from campus, really. But that is really just a small percentage.
There's been a lot this year. It's been
insane. There's been a lot. There's been some that have mildly irritated estates by being pasted on. but everyone else has been stolen and put here in the green room.
But it's been very active. We've had polling stations this year.
We have.
That's new. So we've had in-person voting.
And they gave out free donuts.
Donuts. There were donuts. But it was a good time. I got a sticker. I felt important.
I didn't get a donut.
Because you didn't go?
I didn't go.
What's that about?
Well, I voted anyway. I think this year really has been good for voting, though.
Definitely.
We've got a pretty high percentage of votes. We've got, 18,037 votes
cast.
That's
a lot. What's the turnout? It was 30...
I think it was 26%.
It wasn't 30, I lied.
It wasn't 30%.
It's 20-something percent.
Spreading misinformation on YSTV and URY since 2022, Jess Rolfe.
What? That is a lie. That is mean. That's bad for my character. Well, that's pretty much everything me and Joe have for the moment. We'll be heading over to the main stage, but we haven't heard from Matt and Hannah, actually. ERM presenters are known for many things, but being punctual's not one of them, so I wonder how they're getting on.
Let's see.
Hey,
Matt, where are you?
I'm at D-Bar. Seems pretty closed for a night like ERN, though.
Wait, why are you there?
Because we're presenting?
Yes, you're correct. So why are you not at Central Hall?
What do you mean, Central Hall?
Okay. I know you're a fresher, but surely you know where Central Hall is. You know, it's that big, like, spaceship building in the lake and...
Yeah, I'm not that stupid. So you're telling me everyone's there?
Actually, about that, it's kind of empty here too.
So it's not here, and it's not there, then Where the hell is it?
ERN is on campus at the lounge. Come along.
It's at the lounge. Right, I'll see you there then. And she's already running, isn't she? Phone. Excuse me.
You're listening to University Radio York on 88.3 FM and online, and I need to stop getting distracted.
I'll see you guys later. Have fun, Tanisha!
Good evening, you're watching YSTV. My name is Matthew Keel, and I'm getting incredibly distracted again. Come here.
Matt!
Whoa, finally!
Hi.
What are those?
Oh, let me get changed!
Oh. Come on, we're late!
Okay, quickly, let's go!
Hello, and welcome to Results Night 2024!
Now, this year is a particularly exciting evening, as it's the very first results night where we'll be adding 7 brand new SABs to our Unified Students' Union.
Mm-hmm. And this event is hosted in association with our wonderful student unions who have supported the whole election season. So that is TechSoc, YSTV and URY.
Now, let's introduce ourselves. I'm Matt Keel.
And I'm Hannah Bragman, and we'll be your hosts for this evening as we'll relive the election season high and find out who will be our next student representatives.
Now, make sure to follow along with the action at hashtag YorkSUElections2024. That's hashtag YorkSUElections2024.
And this year, we have seen a fantastic outcome with 36 nominations in total. Give it up for everyone who's nominated. So this year we threw all preconceived notions out of the window with candidates running for 1 of 7 newly created positions.
Now let's have a quick recap of what roles are up for grabs tonight. Academic officer.
Activities officer.
Sports officer.
Union affairs.
Union development.
Equality and inclusions officer.
And community and wellbeing officer.
Our chosen SABs will receive a full-time position working at the University of York's Student Union for a year. During that time, they'll have the chance to deliver on their manifestos and represent the students who have elected them.
Now, they'll be trustees of the union and ensure that the issues that matter most to us will be represented at the university.
So, Matt, how's this all decided then?
I'm glad you asked. See, we did this earlier. Now, single transferable voting, also known as STV, has been used to decide our winners. With this system, a minimum quota of votes must be met for our candidates to be elected.
Now, we will be seeing Ron run in every election. Don't you worry, it's not an overeager candidate, but it stands for Reopen Nominations, which was an option for all 7 roles.
Now, voting will be done in rounds. So, oops.
Here is the first round. Anticipation. So as you can see, that no candidate has reached the threshold of votes, so we'll go to the second round.
So in the first round, Ron was eliminated because no candidate reached the threshold. The lowest is eliminated. And in this round, no candidate has still reached the threshold. And the lowest candidate, candidate four, is eliminated. So we go to another round, the third round.
Oh, it's a close one. But still, the threshold is not reached. So the lowest candidate is eliminated. And we'll go to the final round.
Way! And as we can see, candidate three has reached the lowered threshold after votes from the previous candidates have been retotaled, and candidate three has been elected.
So the graph will show who has the largest amount of votes for each round, but please be aware, everyone, until the threshold has been reached, no candidate will be declared the winner.
Now, often there is more than one round involved, which means that voting majorities could change in the next round.
So, in other words, don't get excited too early. We'll let you know when someone has won.
Now, some rules of you that have been lucky enough to be winners. When the results are announced, the lucky winner will be asked to come on stage for a chat. Remember to pick up a microphone from our lovely tech team. Then you can come straight to our media room afterwards for a quick interview in the Costa, which has now been transformed into a green room.
Woo. And please be sure to show your support for each and every candidate tonight. Everyone has worked really hard to be here.
And of course, results aside, every candidate and their devoted team have worked really, really hard and pulled out all the stops for their campaign. Every cardboard poster, snappy slogan, and curated Instagram post has had a whole lot of heart behind it.
Yeah, I got offered a cacti and some sweets as well. Pretty impressive.
I saw the sweets, actually. I might have indulged in one on the way here.
So let's take a second to give a round of applause to every single candidate who's made it to this election season so special. Also, a big shout out to our commercial services team and our 2023 SABs who have made sure that there are some incredible deals on their favourite cocktail. This is incredible, this bit.
There you go. We have Pierrick's El Presidente, Meely's Pink, definitely not lemonade, Anaretto, Finding Nemo, Mardanian Marmat, CC's cocktail, and Aurora's Eau Triomphante cocktail.
Now, make sure you get these cocktails. They're our SAB's speciality cocktails, and they'll be 2 for $12 over at the bar all night. So make sure you get your drinks in at the intervals.
If I wasn't presenting, I'd be there. Now, as per tradition, election night bingo has returned. Woo! Now, to get up to speed with all of the ERN cliches, make sure to play along.
So the bingo will be on the screen throughout the night, and there'll be copies on the tables.
Which one do you think is going to come up first?
Oh, I'm thinking the swear jar.
Me too.
Careful, guys.
Now, before we begin, I want to remind all candidates that if at any point you need to leave or require support, you're more than welcome. There's a designated quiet space in JP002, which is just across from us, at which will be available all evening in case anybody needs a break at any point.
And if any of you need the toilet, then please head to the one located in the Costa at the back. Make sure you head along the right side by the bar.
You guys ready for some results? Oh, that wasn't loud. Come on, are you ready for some results?
Let's go!
That's more like it. It's time for our very first results of the evening, the academic officer. Let's have a reminder what this role is all about.
Academic officer. The academic officer acts as the key representative for academic issues. This role champions the student voice in all academic decisions at York. They work to create an enriching learning environment for all.
So, we only have one academic officer for this year, Fenella Johnson. But before we find out if Fenella has beaten Ron, let's welcome to the stage Meely, who's going to tell us a little bit about her time as academic officer. Meely!
There we go.
Hello.
Hi there. So, how are you doing tonight?
I'm good. I'm enjoying my cocktail.
As you should. You should be celebrating. So, do you have any words of advice for the upcoming next academic officer?
Please book your lunch in your calendar. Otherwise, people will put meetings there. And listen to your department reps. They know what they're talking about.
Amazing. And what's been your highlight for the year?
Oh, God. Where do I start? lots of assessment policy. Today, I got extensions for student media for Elections of Roses. So if you're doing this next year as TechSoc or student media, you get a free extension. You're welcome.
Yay!
So I guess that's the highlight.
That means a lot to us. Thank you so much.
You do so much work.
Thank you. Give it up for Meely.
Thank you so much. Now it's time for the results of this year's Academic Officer election. Let's take a look. This is the first round of voting, and...
Fenella has reached a quota! Congratulations, Fenella! Please come down to the stage! Fenella, come on down!
Fenella! How are we doing, Fenella? Yay!
Congratulations! How are you feeling?
I just downed my drink, so I think I might be sick.
As you should, celebrate.
No, brilliant. Is there anything you'd like to say to the people who've helped you over the past few weeks with planning and actually getting involved with your campaign?
Yeah, thank you to my team who are all sat over there, to Katie in particular who made all those really, really amazing posters, and to Ron for putting up a good fight, but you just weren't good enough.
Pesky old Ron.
Absolutely brilliant. How are you going to celebrate the rest of the night?
Carry on downing my drinks.
Yes, you should.
Sounds like a good idea.
Brilliant. Thank you so much. Give it up to Fenella.
And there you have it, our first result of the evening. Fenella has been elected as Academic Officer. Let's hear a little about Fenella's promises.
Hiya, my name's Fenella Johnson and I'm running for Academic Officer this year. My manifesto points are to ensure no major deadlines fall on the same or consecutive days of each other. I want to introduce extensions for all sports teams, specifically around Roses and Varsity. And I want to introduce feedback and guidance hours across all of the departments in York. I also want to introduce a transition orientation day for all students with a disability. This is a chance to come to campus and meet academic staff and other students as well as to work their way around campus before term starts. I want to create a space for online and distance learners to come to access campus whenever they can and to meet each other to create a better community. I also want to introduce informal research sharing sessions for PGR students to get practice before their formal examinations. And finally, I want to create an online forum for all students and alumni to share job opportunities and connect with each other easily.
There's going to be a lot of wooing and cheering today.
Get used to it.
So the candidates for your next activities officer are Herman Vindosa Gomez,
Satna Keshava,
Kaitlyn Beattie-Zarb,
and Chu Young Jung.
So to leave you all in anticipation, we have an exclusive interview with the University of York's radio election lead, Finn Cudmore.
Woo! There you go. Hi, Fen. So, just a little about tonight. Thank you so much once again for helping organise everything tonight. So, what does your role entail when you're producing a night like this?
So, I first started talking about this in like October, November with YSTV's production director, Cameron. And last year we did separate broadcasts, this year we're doing the same one. So that's basic setup and then choosing presenters. So, I chose Matt to present for URY on stage. Aww. And not Anna, unfortunately. That was YSTV. And then choosing, crewing, and just getting everything in the right place at the right time.
So there you go, you heard it here, everybody. Me being here is Finn's fault. So what goes into production behind the scenes? What's happening over in that corner behind that wall right now?
There's a lot of people freaking out to varying degrees about timings and making sure everything's actually being broadcast. Making sure no one swears when they're being interviewed after winning is the big thing of like, please don't. Just please don't. That breaks Ofcom and we get in trouble.
Yes.
So it's a lot of figuring out what can go wrong and trying to stop it.
Because, of course, tonight we're not just being broadcast on YSTV, we're also on air on University Radio York on 88.3 FM and also online on the website. So, how long has been planning going on for this?
In intensity, about 2 months since I got back from Christmas. And then early stages, we had meetings in December with YUSU. And we start planning this from the moment it ends, the year before we kind of figure out what went wrong and figure out what we can do better every year.
Wow, so it's a long, almost year-round operation for this, which is must be spectacularly tiring. And you must also be very busy tonight. So we'll let you get on your way. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much. You can tell they're important from the clipboard.
No, absolutely. And also, can we just get a huge round of applause for everybody working behind the scenes tonight? for URY, YSTV and Technical Theatre Society.
You can't see them, but there is a lot of people making tonight happen. So now that we've heard from Finn, let's take a look at who will be the union's next activities officer.
Here's the first round of voting.
So the threshold has not been met and the lower candidate will be removed.
And we move on to the second round of voting. Getting closer, but this time the threshold has not been met again, so the lowest candidate, I believe, will be removed. And therefore, it's a race of two going into the last round of voting.
And the threshold has been reached. Kaitlyn is our new officer. Please welcome Kaitlyn to the stage.
That was terrifying. that was not what I was expecting at all.
Wow, well, congratulations, you've done it, you've been elected. Is there anyone you'd like to thank?
A lot of people, I don't know, like all the student media, because I know you're all out there and you're the reason I'm here, 100%.
Oh, there you go, and what are you most looking forward to doing in this role?
I think societies want me to say storage, so storage.
It's been a bit of a big talking point around USU at the moment, is the storage. And how are you going to be celebrating your election win tonight?
I haven't had a sab cocktail yet, so I'm going to get a sab cocktail.
Get yourself over there and get yourself a sab cocktail. While you do that, why don't we take a look at your manifesto? Give it up for Kaitlyn!
Congratulations.
I'm Kaitlyn, I'm a third-year PPE student, and I'm running to be your activities officer. During my time at university, I've also been the editor of York Vision, a producer at YSTV, a presenter at URY, a delegate at UNA, a projectionist at York Student Cinema, a netball umpire, a student expert panelist, the list goes on. I clearly love activities at York, but I also understand firsthand how hard it is to get involved in activities and remain involved. That's why I want to focus on accessibility for all, longevity for all, and a bigger picture for all. I want to make sure there is better support, better funding, better storage, better training for student societies and society leaders. Most importantly, I want to hear from you, prioritize your voices and first-hand experiences to figure out what exactly needs fixing and how. I want to ensure that activities remain an asset, not a burden, and that activities always remain available for all.
So there we have it, our first two elected candidates for tonight. Give it up once again for Kaitlyn and Fenella.
Wow, so exciting. Well, we're gonna have a little break now.
So now is your chance to head over to the bar, it's right there, and go and make the most of those two for £12 deals. And we'll be right back with the rest of the results. We'll see you in a bit.
Thank you, bye.
Hello. We did not know that we were live, and we are live here in the green room.
Hi. Welcome back to the green room. We're here with our new academic officer, Fenella. How are you feeling?
Very good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, we've got some really serious questions for you now.
Perfect.
So first of all, the big question on everyone's mind here, obviously, you ran opposed.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about your opponent now, having been victorious?
Who was the opponent, Jay?
Have you got any hard feelings towards Ron?
Do you know what? I think I can let it go a bit. He did put up a good fight. Mm. Was considering leaving York for good if Ron won tonight. I'll have to call my dad and let him know he doesn't have to pick me up.
And he doesn't have to harm Ron whatsoever.
No. Yes.
No.
But, yeah.
Well, commiserations to Ron. you put up a fight, though, because you've been campaigning. I've seen your posters.
Thank you.
I loved your posters.
Thank you.
There's some on the back here. Don't let your vote scoot away. In the toilets, there's don't let your vote get
go
flushed.
Go down the toilet, yeah.
Genius stuff. So
I want to talk about, sorry, I completely forgot about this when we were planning this. Outside Nisa, the humongous
banner.
Yeah.
And the teddy bear.
And the teddy bear.
When did that go up?
Sunday afternoon. Oh. I had people pick up banners and I was like, nah, mine's going there.
Yeah. Well, what was your favourite part about all of the campaigning process?
the drinking? No, I had a really good time speaking to people, and making the posters was really fun, but I have consumed a lot of wine this week.
Fair enough.
I mean, you've got to. Yeah. You do have to. So what's your first priority now you've been elected?
Tonight
well, or yeah, in tonight. Like...
you can go with the serious answer or the very silly
answer.
Yeah,
because I know what I'm going to go tonight. I'm going to finish off my drinks now, and then we're going to go to Flair's.
Oh, yeah. Now, that's my academic officer.
What's your go-to Flair's tune? What's your favourite club tune?
Fergalicious.
Oh, Joe's got a very distinctive one.
Right, the thing is, with mine, so it's been popularised by the TV show Saltburn, but I want to say, I want to be that guy and say I was there first.
Yeah.
I'm Sophie Ellis-Bextor's original fan. So
loves a bit of Murder on the Dance Floor.
Oh, nice.
Absolutely. But where are we? What?
A really serious question now.
What is the biggest challenge facing students going to be in the next academic year, do you think?
So, as I said at debate night and across my campaign, I don't think there's a singular issue that's going to affect all students in the same way. I think that the most prevalent issue right now is the problem of deadlines that's come about as part of semesterization, with a lot of them falling on the same day and on consecutive days. So I think that's definitely my first priority in tackling. And then the rest will hopefully follow suit.
Awesome.
So now, after that very serious question, we are going to hop into a little game that we've played.
Are we?
Okay. We are.
What about the question I wanted to ask?
Ask it. Go on. I dare you.
Very serious question I really want to ask you.
Go on.
If you could, you have to pick to fight.
Okay.
One horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses?
100 horse-sized. That one.
100 horse-sized ducks.
Why? They would.
I'd go for that.
Imagine them climbing all over you.
Could you imagine the beak on a horse-sized duck?
I reckon I could headbutt a horse-sized duck.
I don't think you could.
I think interesting question. I think I'll think of that for the rest of the night.
Let it
at 3 a.m.
No, you won't be waking up in flares. You'll be in flares. Sorry, you won't be waking up at 3 a.m. You'll be at 3 a.m.
I'll be in flares.
In flares.
I want to see that written on paper.
Going around going, what do you think about this?
Yeah. No. Right,
so
what's the game?
The game is something that we came up with Finn, our producer. It's obviously we are known for our waterfowl here at the University of York. Mm-hmm. We love a duck.
Yeah.
We love a goose. We love a duck goose. So the game is called That's Foul.
Oh, I should have said it when you said it. That's Foul!
No, missed it.
No, we ruined it.
So basically, we have a list of fake ducks,
okay,
and we have a list of real ducks.
Yeah.
And I want you to tell us which ones are real and which ones are fake.
Are you ready?
Okay.
Okay. We'll go for the first one. So, number one is the silver appleyard duck. Is that real or fake?
Real.
That is correct. as soon as I reveal it, I cough.
Right, we've got, what should we go for? The flat-footed duck.
Real?
That is fake. That's a fake duck.
Absolutely
not. Not real.
We've got the short-haired grass duck.
Fake. But now I feel like you said it's real.
That is correct.
Wait, is it fake?
Yeah. It's fake.
Okay, cool.
Oh, no. we need those iPads they've got out there.
We certainly do.
We do.
I think we are going to have to wrap up here. We didn't get through enough of That's Foul, but we...
I wasn't keeping score, but I think you did great. And you're going to do great as academic officer.
I hope so.
Awesome. We're looking forward to seeing what you do.
Thanks very much for joining us here in the green room. And we're going to get straight back to some democracy on the main stage.
Are we? No, we're not, Joe.
No, we're not.
We're going to talk to Kaitlyn Beattie-Zarb.
Okay.
Can you switch on?
No.
We're on air. Are we on air?
No.
We're still on air. Hi. Can we swap it?
So,
Fenella,
yeah.
We'll see you later. Enjoy your night. Enjoy your
Thank
podcast.
You very much.
Kaitlyn, our new activities officer.
Unfortunately,
welcome
you see,
to URY. Welcome to YSTV.
Hi. Yeah.
We used to radio, unfortunately. So these things.
I love that you have signals at me. I don't know what they mean.
I just love. We're still on air. No. That's the highlight anyone wants to hear backstage of YSTV.
We are still on air. But how are you feeling? You've just won activities officer.
Fine.
You're chilling.
Is that convincing?
Not phased.
Yeah, I don't know. It was the scariest bit. That was the moment I was most terrified of.
But so you've won now. You can chill.
I can chill. I can go have a cocktail.
Have you tried any of the sab cocktails yet?
I was late and then I didn't get to buy
Is there any that you've got your eye on?
Yeah, somebody's already said they're literally buying me an El Presidente right now.
Pierrick is so excited about that.
Oh, yeah. We spoke to Pierrick earlier and he's very happy.
He's very excited about it. But
the cocktail. Yeah.
But definitely get on that. But your activities officer, What inspired you to run for this role? What activities have you been involved in while you've been at uni?
Me and Jess know a very
obvious
one.
We know, but tell the people, they want to know.
I've been in a lot of activities to the extent that I had housemates last year say, oh, we never see you. And I was like, yeah, sorry.
I'm doing activities.
I'm doing activities. So yeah, I've been on YSTV, URY.
Big up.
I'm the editor of York Vision. I got to remember that one. Co-editor. Sorry, Emily. she's
sorry,
watching.
Matt, I don't know what, oh, is it Matt that's co-editor?
No, it's Emily Sinclair.
Get sorry, with
Emily.
It.
So really sorry, Emily, if you're out there.
wherever you may be.
Yeah. I've done, Model UN, York Student Cinema, basically half of the media committee, if I'm being honest now.
Do you feel well prepped going into this role?
Sure. I don't know. Can you feel
really
prepped?
I think you'll be great.
Thank
I think you've got this.
So, are there any adopter societies that you want to see reincarnated?
Somebody warned me about this question. I know about Princess Diana Society has two members right now. So,
Hugh Cummins is a former president and former member of URY.
So, if they ever go out of business, I'd like to bring them back. I think that's quite sweet. I don't know. I'd need to have a look at their list.
Condiment Society.
Yeah, Condiment Society's one where people just tried different
dips.
Dips.
I support it, but I don't
do you
think
support
I would.
Dips?
I don't think I would.
Can you tell the people, on dips? Kaitlyn, do you support dips?
I'm not the biggest dip fan.
Ketchup or mayo?
Yeah, ketchup or mayo.
Or mayo.
Ketchup or mayo.
Ketchup and mayo.
Oh, Kaitlyn.
With a little bit of a Tesco pizza.
That is disgusting. It's one or the other.
Listen, she's for
I prefer,
all.
Like, exactly.
She's a candidate for all.
I can't pick a dip.
Ketchup
you're
and
a, you're
mayo
a spin
fans.
Doctor, Jess Rolfe.
I'm
that's
spinning.
What you are.
Spinning. Right, but obviously you've been involved in a lot of societies, a lot of media societies as well in there. What is your favourite media society and why is it URY?
It's not URY.
And that was Kaitlyn Beattie-Zarb, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks so much for talking to us.
No,
you
really
may never re-enter.
That's a bad choice.
That's the wrong answer.
No, it's a real question.
So they both have perks. They're both wonderful in different ways.
You don't have to answer this.
I will say URY is easier to get shows. Sorry, YSTV. Because I have two URY shows and no YSTV shows.
Harvey Miller is currently doing a victory dance.
A little dance.
Behind
but
the cameras.
But YSTV's fun and they do stuff like this. And I'm really sad that I'm not behind the scenes, actually. I'm really sad.
You're in front
I'm
of the cameras
camera.
Now, Kaitlyn.
In the lights.
You're a politician.
Yeah.
Oh, don't say that.
How's it feel?
Fine.
Yeah, what's the best bit of campaigning that you've done?
Can I say debate night?
Yeah.
I think it was debate night. That was a lot of fun. And
CIM was just a bit rubbish then, yeah.
CIM was good, but I had 5 minutes and it was panic.
Yeah.
And it was the first thing. Debate night was fun. I liked making the posters actually as well. It was sort of a creative outlet.
Yeah. I guess obviously you do Vision and URY and other creative outlets, but you don't get to use Canva that often.
No,
so.
I never use Canva. I'm not the best at Canva, which is why you'll see on my campaign Instagram, it took me so long to get anything posted. I posted barely anything because I just...
You know what? It's quality over quantity.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's clearly the case.
I appreciate
because you've
that.
Won. But you mentioned Tesco Pizza earlier.
Yeah.
So I have a query for you.
Okay.
You're a politician. You're a mind. Why does round pizza come in a square box?
Oh.
I want to hear your theory.
Because it makes it more interesting?
Just for flair.
I think
appearance.
So. Appearance. I mean... I don't know. There's a design element. I'm trying to think of a counterexample I can give you. That's my philosophy brain, but it tastes better that way.
And also, I think that it's really difficult to print round boxes in cardboard.
True.
Not
and
with that attitude.
How would you get the pizza out if it's round? Because if you just get stuck on the side.
Surely it's still slicing.
Listen,
though.
We're going to have to go back to the main
pizzas?
Stage now, but we'll join Matt and Hannah on the stage.
Welcome back to Results Night 2024! Now, we have a special interview now with Ben Vulliamy, the CEO of the Student Union. He's going to chat to us a bit about what it means to have so many students running for the sabbatical officer role. So, Ben!
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm all right. This is quite tense, isn't it?
It is a bit. It's the lights and everyone, isn't
it? Yeah, I can't see anything. Yeah,
yeah, no. So if you were a student tonight running for one of the roles, what role would you be running for?
long by officer or something, or chief bureaucrat maybe, I don't know. I mean, to be honest, I've never been a sabbatical officer. I am full of admiration for anyone who is brave enough to stand and craft a vision, so, yeah.
Amazing. Do you have any tips for them?
I have absolutely nothing valuable to offer them at all.
Oh, fair dues. Okay, and have you tried any of the cocktails yet? Do you have a favourite?
I haven't tried a cocktail. I'm quite disappointed there isn't a Benji on the Beach cocktail.
A Benji on the Beach? Yeah. Maybe we should chat to them.
It would have been a kind of, you know, very fruity, fruity flavour. Yeah.
Oh, nice. Rum or vodka or what would you pick?
No idea at all. something really lame and pathetic and cheap and horrible.
You know what? We're all students. We'll drink anything, won't we? And have the elections this year felt a bit different for you?
Yeah, they felt really different. Incredibly diverse fields of candidates. And actually, you could see the diversity in their manifestos as well. I thought they were really rich with both some kind of long-standing student interests like accommodation and mental health and so on and so on, but also some new things like internationalisation and kind of community building in different ways. So very different and really fantastic.
Amazing. What are you most excited for the next year for the new SABS officers?
I mean, every year is a wonderful change. I mean, it's one of the reasons I work here is because there's this new energy, new ideas coming through every year. And as much as I love the outgoing officers, you know, it's good that there is a cycle of change and gives me new energy as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And any last things you want to say to everyone here tonight?
I'd say a massive thank you. Thank you to the candidates. Thank you to the campaigners who supported them. Thank you to the 5,800 and whatever it was who voted.
Wow.
Thank you to the student media. It's a rare, weird thing to kind of celebrate democracy like this. So thank you, everyone. You've been fantastic.
Thank you so much, Ben. Everyone give up for Ben.
Now, give us a cheer if you're ready for some more results. That is way more enthusiastic than when I first asked.
There we go. So before we begin, I would like to remind everyone that the voting includes multiple rounds before the threshold is met. So please do not get too excited too early.
That's what we like to hear. Keep the tension going. And next up, we have the quite anticipated from earlier's crowd reaction, sports officer.
So let's hear what it is like to be sports officer then.
Sports officer. The sports officer promotes and enhances the sports offering at York. They lead the sports committee and strive to make sports welcoming and accessible for everyone.
Thanks, Ollie Whitmore. Now, your candidates for sports officer are Ben Clark.
Harvey Charlesworth.
Jonathan Van der Lith.
And a rerunner, TJ.
Let's have a look at who you have elected. This is the first round of voting. It's very tense when these graphs go up like this. And as we can see, it's quite even at the top, actually. TJ slightly in the lead, Jonathan in third, actually. Harvey's in second. And Ron will be eliminated after the first round. And Ben Clark as well, unfortunately.
So on to the second round now. It still remains a very close competition. But the lowest is Jonathan with 777, so he will be eliminated. Now for the final round.
It's a two-horse race for now. TJ against Harvey Charlesworth. Who will break the top? And it is Tanisha Jain, just by ever so slightly, has been re-elected as sports officer. Congratulations, TJ.
Congratulations, TJ. Come on down to the stage. Oh.
Sorry, I'm going to need a minute to breathe.
No, that's okay. Wow, it was quite a competition. Are you surprised? Are you happy?
I'm very, very happy. I'm very, very happy. Thank you to my competitors. It was a very, very, very tough race. It's been one of the toughest weeks of my entire life. And I wouldn't have put in as much effort if my competitors didn't put in so much as well.
And of course, it's been a long campaign for you as well. So what was your favorite part of your campaign this year?
I think it was the, honestly, the endorsements. I think that sounds bad, but it was just overwhelming to see so many people who some of them I'd never met before willing to endorse me and saying these amazing things, being like, you've made an impact in our life and we want you to continue. And that's just something I've always wanted in my life, to just have an impact on other people. And yeah, that was...
Wow, it's incredible that you have, and you're going to have more of an impact this next year. Do you have any plans?
Oh, yes. big plans.
Amazing. Well, we're going to hear from your manifesto now, so give it up to TJ.
Hi, my name is Tanisha Jain, or TJ as you might know me, and I'm running to be your sports officer again in 2024. I believe sports is so much beyond just competing. It is about building a community, reducing hate, promoting well-being, and more. To me, sports is not just a hobby. It is my strength, my integrity, and my ultimate passion. With this passion, let's dive right into my manifesto. As the current officer, I will continue to work tirelessly to ensure that our sports program reflects the rich diversity of our university, embracing individuals of all backgrounds, identities, genders, and abilities through inclusive policies, diverse representation, and equitable opportunities. I want to showcase the positive impact of physical activity on mental health and collaborate with University Mental Health Services to deliver a mental health gym referral program to promote mental well-being through exercise. And of course, the cost of living has affected us all, with most clubs and individuals struggling to keep up with the cost of sport. I want to review the true cost of sport at York and present it to the university to sustain and increase funding available for the same.
Wow, how exciting for the next year. We've got TJ on board. So next up, we have the Union Affairs. So this is a brand new role of the evening. It's hotly contested. Your elective Union Affairs Officer will act as the head of union and take on leadership roles as chair of the trustee board.
I believe we have a little clip to show you about what it means.
Union Affairs Officer. The Union Affairs Officer acts as the head of the union. This role represents and advocates for the students in talks with the university and wider organisations. They'll also chair our trustee board and act as the liaison between the students' union and the college presidents.
Very exciting indeed. But before we hear the candidates for this role, let's welcome the, well, current and then shortly former president of the student union. I'm so sorry. Was that a bit harsh? Sorry. Pierrick to the stage. Talk about his two years stint in the role. Pierrick, welcome.
Not former yet.
I'm so sorry. Okay. I lost myself in words. How does it feel to watch election results nights? And does it feel very different from when you were running?
It doesn't, actually. It's still nerve-wracking. I know so many of the candidates, so I'm just nervous for them more than anything, as much as I was nervous for myself before. So.
It's a very tense occasion. Now, of course, the role name has changed slightly, but it's still acting as the head of the students' union. So do you have any words of advice for your successors?
Not particularly. Every president's different. What I would say to the successor is don't actually run onto stage once without having actually won your race, because I did that. It's a bit embarrassing. So just don't do that. Wait to be called on stage. Don't get too eager.
It's quite a complicated voting system, and as you can already see, it's produced some really tense results. Now, how does it feel to see these new roles being created?
Well, I made them, so
there you go.
Really well.
Your own incarnation.
Yeah, my creation, if you will. But no, it feels really nice. I think it's more accessible as a team, and it's obviously expanded, which is great. More representatives.
Well, thank you so much for your time, and thank you for your two years in charge of the Students' Union. Everyone, please give it up once again for Pierrick.
You'll love Pierrick.
I feel really bad about it. I'm so sorry, nonetheless.
So, we have some candidates running for this role, of course. So, let's find out who they are. We've got Isaac Hotchkiss.
Lewis Parrey.
Louis McVeigh.
And Mardin Nasir.
Wow, lots of people with lots of support for this role. So, in the first round, the threshold...
Here we go.
Has it been met?
Let's find out.
It's very slow, isn't it? It's not been met. So, we're going to eliminate the two lowest, which is Louis and Ron.
There we go. Moving on to the next round. So the second round, we have Lewis, Parrey, Isaac, and Marden. Who's going to meet it this time? If anyone, it's getting a bit more even at the top. Marden and Lewis coming out as the two leaders, which means we have to say goodbye to Isaac in the second round of voting. Moving on to the third and potentially final round.
The votes are redistributed. Who will reach the quota?
And it is Lewis Parrey.
Congratulations to Lewis.
Congratulations. Lewis Parrey has been elected as your new Union Affairs Officer. Come on up to the stage.
Thank you. Oh my God.
So, instant reaction. How does it feel to be the first ever winner of the Union Affairs role?
Like, I don't even know. I don't even know what I'm feeling. I can't even describe it. Like, that the whole results was just not how I expected it to go.
Yeah, it was an intense one, wasn't it? So, what are you most excited for about the role?
I think just kind of representing students and trying to make a change as much as I can. And hopefully delivering on my manifesto.
And what's the first thing you're going to do after tonight?
I think we're going to Flares tonight.
Ooh, Flares!
What's your favourite song to dance to at Flares?
Oh, God. Murder on the Dance Floor.
Nice. Very, very good choice. Do you feel slightly more relaxed now the campaign's over, or are you a bit excited about the road ahead?
No, this is like as stressed as I've ever been, I think.
And have you had any cocktails? What are you going to drink to celebrate?
I've had the Pierrick one.
Got to be the El Presidente.
I have to work my way through the list, I think, tonight.
Amazing. Any final words you want to say? Anyone you want to thank?
I just want to thank all of my campaign team over there. You've been amazing. They've been, like, honestly more, like, passionate about this than I have somehow. So just thank you. Like, I literally could never have done this without you.
Incredible. Congratulations. Give it up for Lewis.
Well done, Lewis.
Hi, guys. I'm Lewis, and I'm running to be your Union Affairs Officer. As David Cato President, I campaigned hard on the issues against the uni. Now I'm ready to do this on an even bigger scale with my bold and achievable manifesto. Starting with a better union and university, I want to rebuild the connection between students and their union, to make the uni actually include college and academic reps in their decision making, and to improve support for international students when they arrive in York. Next, cost of living. I want to improve easy access to student jobs, work to stop unaffordable rent increases, to make expensive sports and societies cheaper and more accessible, and lead the charge in lobbying the government to increase student maintenance loans. Finally, improving our campus by creating a USU space to improve access to resources like the student pantry, lobbying the uni to increase funding for colleges, fighting for more on-campus returners accommodation, and a more reliable first bus service. We need a Union Affairs Officer who is passionate and not afraid to challenge the uni. So vote Lewis.
There we go, and once again, congratulations to Lewis on becoming the first Union Affairs Officer. Now, our next role that will be elected tonight is the Equality and Inclusion Officer. Let's hear what this new role is all about.
Equality and Inclusion Officer. The Equality and Inclusion Officer advocates for marginalised and underrepresented communities at the university. They will address systemic barriers and create an inclusive environment for the university.
Incredible, and don't forget to keep on using that hashtag as well. So, let's find out the candidates for the Equality and Inclusions Officer. They are Julian Deacon.
Jade Hudson Hicks.
Sam Palin.
Ezreal Shear.
Ilona Setti.
Freddie Newell.
Jesse Machin.
And Xiaopu Wong.
Wow, we have a lot of candidates for this one. So the competition is very high, but we can honestly say you've all done such a great job in all of your campaigns.
Yes, thank you very much. Obviously, you've put in a lot of hard work, but now it's time to see the results. Let's see who makes it out of the first round of voting. It always looks so tight when the voting's just starting, doesn't it?
So it's very slow.
But we've got Freddie, Ezreal, Alona, and Xiaopu coming out on top. But now that means we have to say goodbye to Julian, and Ron will stay in for the second round of voting.
So in the second round, they're slowly creeping up, but we will say goodbye to the lowest candidates now, Jade, Sam, Jesse, and Ron. Moving on to the next round, will the threshold be reached?
Four in at this time, Freddie, Ezreal, Alona, and Xiaopu. And look how even that is.
Oh,
that's
it is a
almost
tight one.
636, 692, 610, 622. It's really close. Coming out in front is Ezreal, but sadly, Alona doesn't quite make the cut this time. And into the fourth round we go.
Will this be the final round? Will the threshold be met? Not quite yet. Again, very tight. Freddie with 761, Ezreal with 810, and Xiaopu with 742.
Which means we say goodbye to Xiaopu, and it's the final, hopefully, round with Freddie and Ezreal. In the fifth round of this election, who will make the cut? It's
Ezreal.
Just by a very fine margin, Ezreal has been voted as your Equality and Inclusion Officer. Congratulations. Do you want to come up to the stage?
Good song choice.
Congratulations, Ezreal.
Thank you.
Has it sunk in that you've won?
I'm so excited. I cannot believe that. I got it, bro.
No, well done.
What's been your favorite part about the campaign?
I think like all my commentators are so great, excellent. They work so hard and it's hard for me to get like commentary with them, but I'm lucky. I'm just lucky. I got luck, yeah.
No, absolutely. And what are you most looking forward to in your new role?
I think like I will pay much attention to international students and LGBTQ community and also disability students here in New York. I would like work with uni to make them pay much more attention to this, and I will do my best to make our campus much better.
Amazing. And is there anything you'd like to say to your team?
Oh, I love you guys. Aww. Thanks for your support. Here, I shout out to Yuvi, Eva, Boovi, Delina, Joy, Kainan, and I got support from Chinese community and Indian community, also my fellows from Africa. Thank you so much.
Amazing. Give it up for Ezreal.
Congratulations. Let's take a look what Ezreal has promised to do in the next year in a 60-second manifesto.
Hi, everyone. This is Ezreal, and I'm running for the position of Equality and Inclusion Officer. As an international student, I totally understand how important is equality and inclusion on campus, and it's necessary for us to pay much more attention to the needs of minorities and address the issues in a timely manner. If I am elected, I will try my best to solve the problems faced by minorities on campus and meet their needs. I will work with the university to help increase like welfare policy and scholarship for international students. I will also organize like educational activities and training LGBTQ plus topics, and also increase like campus fixtures for like students with disabilities.
How exciting! Wow! Give up for Ezreal one more time, and all the candidates have been elected so far. Cheering's dying down a bit.
I'll keep cheering.
Thank you, Meely.
Everybody is settling in with their cocktails. It's time to get some more if you don't, because we're going for another little break.
Absolutely. So make sure you come back very soon, and don't forget to use the hashtag York SU Elections 2024. Get involved with all the action, and we'll see you very soon.
Hi, we're here with Tanisha Jain, your newly re-elected sports officer. Tanisha, how are you feeling?
I mean, this is going to sound very typical, but I just can't believe it. I feel so surreal, so overwhelmed, but mainly surreal.
Is it different or the same to how you felt last year?
It's so different. You think running the first time is stressful, rerunning is so much worse. It's just so much more pressure. It's like almost doubled. And yeah, it is different, but I'm just glad I can help students for another year. So I think that in that way, it does feel a bit same.
Well, you were obviously our previous sports officer. So looking back on the past year, what's been your favorite thing about being in the role?
I think my favorite thing being in the role has been able to represent a lot of communities that previously weren't represented in some ways. For example, we were able to start a South Asian League, and I think we're the only university in the country doing that. And I'm not taking any credit. That's to our great societies, but being a South Asian, it was great to be able to support them and, you know, have something like that at a university and represent students.
So doing sport for the past year, have you been able to keep, I know you're a keen cricketer, have you been able to keep up with your cricket? Have you taken on any new sports?
No, so I do basketball and cricket.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Check your facts.
I have tried to keep up with it. It's been a bit difficult. Just like literally, I only got back 5 days before the elections. I had to take a month off due to personal reasons, but I've tried. It is very good for the stress of the job. So yeah, I'm just going to keep talking about my role, but yeah.
And how are you feeling about your second roses? Are you hoping for a different result? I know the answer to that one.
I mean, you know what? I think away roses is always difficult. I'm more excited about the home roses I get to do now because I've got so many ideas that it's going to just, I think it's going to be a different roses than anybody's ever seen.
Oh, exciting. Talking about roses though, your jacket. Can we just look at this, please?
Can we zoom in on the jacket?
Can we get a zoom on this jacket? Custom for roses, you said.
Yeah,
what dedication.
I'm a dedicated sports officer.
Absolutely.
I got my jacket customized for roses.
And roses are pink, of course.
Yeah, because, you know, I believe that friendship can be made through sports. Maybe not with Lancaster, but of course it can be. So as a sports officer, I would try to at least try and be a bit more friendly with our
ranks. Someone's been media trained.
Oh, yeah. That's my sports officer.
So we keep it serious here on University Radio York and on YSTV. If a giraffe were to wear a tie, where would it go?
If a giraffe?
Like top of the neck? Bottom of the neck?
No, bottom of the neck.
Bottom of the neck.
It's got to be bottom of the neck.
But don't you think it's like, it's got to interact with the chin in some way, you know? You've got to have that distance.
It's got
there.
To hang off the body. So it's got to be...
Yeah,
there.
It's
got to
frame
it's got
it.
To hang off the body, so it's got to be bottom of the
neck.
I
was genuinely expecting like a funny answer or something, but that's genuinely
that's
does make
funny.
Sense.
I'm a realistic person, guys, what can I say?
Definitely. Right, we've got a little game for you.
Of course.
If I can find it, you're going to be really impressed.
Can Joe not be in it? Because I heard what he had to say about our tomato in the box game, and I was very disappointed.
Listen, that was in comparison to carrot in a box,
slashed.
Okay? Tomato in a box.
Tomato.
tomato in a box was, it was fine. It was fine. It was pretty good.
Wow.
But
sure.
It's not carrot in a box. Seriously.
Well, on that note, our game is called Finish the Campaign Slogan. So obviously lots of slogans this year. Don't look behind you.
Don't look behind you, TJ.
We're going to give you some slogans, half finished.
Okay.
Tell us whose slogan it was. Ready? So I'm just...
Jen.
I'm just Jen.
I love that
obviously.
One.
Okay, number two. Drive the union forward.
Whose slogan
was James Shriver.
Yeah.
Correct.
We've got a union for everyone.
Isaac?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we've got insert catchy tagline here. That'll do.
Oh, I actually have no idea.
That was Scotty for Community and Wellbeing.
That'll do, Scotty.
No, I was doing well.
We've got I Will Provide. Came with a lovely song. Yeah.
I love the song.
The song
fair.
Was great.
We've got Don't Let Your Vote Scoot Away. Don't Let Your Vote Scoot Away.
Was it Louis by any chance?
No.
Nope. No, I have no idea.
Your newly elected academic officer, Fenella.
Oh,
it's got like the electric scooter
fair,
on
yeah,
it.
To be fair, Fenella had many a campaign.
Oh, there was so
yeah,
many. There
that
was like,
is why, to be
I
fair,
loved
I love. I know one, and Fenella's campaign slogans was insane.
No, they're great. There
it's
was
very difficult to choose one.
Outside the library, there's one. It's like to the student crying over your destination. I've got you.
I just saw one in the toilet, which was like, don't let your vote go down
Flush,
the toilet.
Oh,
and I was
it's
like,
amazing.
That's really smart.
I think we've got a final one here, which is pick something.
Picnic. I love that one as well.
There have been some catchy slogans this
year.
But yours have been really eye-catching, your big cardboard.
Oh, thank
very
you.
Impressive.
Yeah. Wasn't there one about hoops?
It's because I'm a basketball player.
Yes.
It's like hoops, I did it again, because also like we love a
hoops
bit of Britney.
Hoops, I did it again, that was it. Yes, Britney.
Yeah.
I love a bit of Britney. But listen, we're unfortunately going to have to say goodbye to you, Tanisha. But we'll, of course, see you at Roses, and we'll see you throughout the year. So
of
thank
course.
You so much for joining us here in the green room.
Thank you
so much,
and we're
going
to go to our new Union Affairs Officer,
We're
going to
swap you out for our new Union Affairs Officer. We've got no cut screen.
We're
just going to do it live.
We're playing musical chairs here on URY and YSTV.
Hello, Lewis. How do you feel? Union Affairs Officer.
I literally don't know how to feel. Like, there's just so many emotions going on. I can't even describe it. I don't know.
Speechless. In shock.
So, what's been the best bit of your campaigning?
I think, honestly, just, like, my friends, my campaign team, just, like, having them around, working as a team, like, they've just been so amazing, and I never could have got through this without them.
I want to say on your campaign that I respect the bit of you wearing those stupid Vote Lewis glasses in a lecture. I walked into my thinking lecture.
No,
yeah, you were sat in
the
courtyard.
I was like wearing them because I'd like go to something like a campaign thing, have the sunglasses on, and then just forget, and I'd just wear them for the rest of the day. I wouldn't even realize.
I was just walking past, and I didn't know you were in my lectures until I saw you with just on your head, Vote Lewis.
Yeah.
Never stop campaigning.
Never stop the grind.
Clearly, it's paid off.
Yeah.
Here
somehow.
You are. But on your campaign, I've seen your TikTok. I've seen the fan cams.
Yeah.
Where did they come from?
I have to say, okay, so...
did you make them?
My friend Emma, on my campaign team, she basically did all the social media, including the TikToks, and just kind of went crazy. Just was like rolling stuff out, and I just let her do it.
They are very
so
funny.
Yeah, it wasn't me. I was not making like fan edits of myself, don't worry.
Okay.
So, Lewis, we're going to take a serious note here.
Okay.
You need to lock in for this question.
I'm ready.
So what is your kind of plan to organize the manhunt for the CompSci toilet bandit?
The what?
Have you not seen this story?
Toilet bandit. The person who destroyed the toilets in CompSci.
Oh.
And the sink.
I don't know.
And the toilet brush holder.
I have not thought about that,
but
maybe we should think into that.
Maybe.
Yeah.
We should have asked this on candidate interview night.
Absolutely, okay, we should.
I mean, USU love giving out like... win like your chance to win £300.
Maybe you should do that. £300 if you turn yourself in as the CompSci toilet bandit.
You heard it here first. Well, you're obviously Union Affairs, brand new role, head of the union-ish, I think.
So we should expect that you know about York.
You should know a lot about York.
And the university.
Oh, God.
You should be on this.
So we've got a quiz.
We're going to see if this is true.
It's quick fire. And
okay.
I can find it.
We're going to ask as many questions as possible in the time that we have left, and we're going to see how many you get right. We are not keeping score. I'm going to look
score?
At Harvey in the background there, and he will give me an inkling of how you're doing. Maybe, if he can be bothered.
Thanks, Harvey.
Are you ready? So, Jess, would you like to begin?
Oh, yeah,
ready?
Okay.
Three, two, one.
How many colleges are at York Uni?
11.
Correct.
How old is the Uni of York?
Like 70.
Wrong.
Oh, 60.
60.
Okay.
60 years. Where did Longboy the late great live?
Derwent. Around Derwent.
Derwent is correct.
Correct. How many pubs are there in York?
300.
One for every day of the year. Have you not known this?
Oh, man. Forgot about that. 365.
The pressure's getting to you. Come on.
Yeah. Right. How many Wetherspoons are there in York?
I think there's two.
This
correct.
Is correct.
Nice.
How many libraries are there on campus? Oh, sorry, on Campus West.
One.
Incorrect. I feel like this is a mean question.
No.
There's another library?
There's
three. Oh, but
there's
they're
the
all Borthwick. In the same...
No, but
it's
they're
one
three
building.
Separate...
Yeah.
Sorry, but also, okay. What about like the 24/7 library?
That's a 24/7 study space, not a library.
sorry
to be that guy,
Jess. He's being that guy. Okay, where are we? Seven. Who is older, URY or YSTV? Who was here first?
I want to say YSTV.
It depends who you ask.
It does depend who you ask.
So what's the newest college to be built? You should
David
know this.
Kato!
There
we go. Play.
What's the oldest college?
Oh. Is it Derwent?
Yes.
Yes.
That is one of them.
Nice. Or Langwith.
Yeah.
What's the nickname for Central Hall?
The spaceship.
Correct.
We've given away this question.
Jen
has fallen.
Jen has fallen.
Sorry, Jen. Clearly not Knuff. Please laugh. What department had the mystery poo bandit earlier this year?
Oh, you just said it.
We
was
just
it computer
said it.
Science?
It was computer science.
What's the name of the cafe in biology?
Biology? Oh, I have no idea.
Come on, that has to be our final question because I'm severely disappointed. It's cookies.
It's cookies.
Oh,
it's my favorite one.
Cookies.
Listen, thanks so much for talking to us, Liz. We're going to cut to our next interview here with Ezreal, our new equality and inclusion officer.
Congratulations, Lewis. Well, congrats, have a great night.
See you later.
Hello.
Hello, hello.
I'll find my page now. 1 second.
Very organized here.
Oh, great. Hello.
Hiya.
Welcome to your YMYSTV. How are you feeling? You've just won.
Oh my God, my heart cannot stop beating. I'm so excited, yeah.
Yeah?
So what inspired you to run for the role of Equality and Inclusion Officer? Obviously it's a new role, so what was the thought process behind your campaign?
I think the campaign is so crazy. All my competitors they do their best and they are so excellent. And I think I won it because it's just lucky. And I represent international students and also LGBTQ community and the disability students here in New York. I think I would work with uni to make them study and live better. Yeah, I would do my best to do that.
Awesome. Have you enjoyed campaigning this week?
I'm so tired for the campaigning. Honestly, I sleep for 2 or 3 hours. Each day, yeah.
I'm going to say, though, you did have a natural advantage, which is your name is very easy to create into a slogan.
What was the slogan?
Slogan is equality is easy and inclusion is real. Vote for Ezreal.
Genius. Actually genius. I was very impressed when I saw that.
So what can students look forward to in the next year in your role?
And I will increasing welfare policies and the scholarship for international students. Because international students should be paid much attention, because it's hard to, for me, I'm a student from China, and I know how hard the international students study here. So they need to be, make uni to pay much attention to this and to help our international students much better. And also I will organize LGBTQ community activities and increasing facilities for the disability student care in New York.
Awesome. Where are we?
We're at the bottom,
At the bottom. Okay, we've got very serious questions here on URY, and we want to ask you, do you think in the world there are more doors or more wheels?
I think more doors.
More doors.
Why?
More doors.
We need your thought process here. Because it's what you haven't taken into consideration is the filing cabinet.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, what?
Because it's got loads of doors, but it's got four
Those
wheels.
Those aren't doors.
Depends what
those are drawers.
What are you saying? What are you saying? That dog's
almost. Yeah.
No, I think it's more wheels. It's obviously more wheels. It's the first thing. I think wheels were invented before doors.
But
ancient man created wheels before doors. Surely.
It depends what you count as a door. Because if you're going to class.
No, because the Neanderthals lived in caves.
What? Did they have doors?
Did they have doors, Ezreal?
Dogs?
Yeah,
we have dogs, yeah.
They
have doors.
They had doors. You've heard it here first. They had doors. What is an NFT?
An NFT?
Bro!
No, say that. It's hard to say that. It's hard to say.
You're going to have to say it. You're going to have to say it. What is an NFT?
NFT?
Yeah.
So I have no idea about it right
Isn't
now.
Is it a non-fungible
It's a non-fungible token, of course.
There are those pictures of monkeys.
Oh, monkeys.
So, of course, we need to tell the students of the University of York about you, and they want to know about their new Equality and Inclusion Officer. Yeah. What music are you listening to at the moment?
Music? I listen hip-hop.
Oh.
What kind? What?
Like Central C, Drake,
So the modern
kind. Rocky. Yeah.
Not the sort of 80s classic hip-hop. Are you more of a modern...
Yeah, modern
contemporary.
Hip-hop. Contemporary. But I also like listening jazz as well.
Very nice.
Awesome.
The thing is, I was about to ask about the horse-sized duck or the 100-duck-sized horse.
No, we can keep this debate going.
Okay, we've had this debate with Fenella, and our final question. Would you rather fight one horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses? So a big duck or loads and loads of tiny horses?
Big duck.
Big duck.
That's the second answer we've
had
of a big duck.
We've got two for two now, because you're Big Duck.
I know, yeah, I'm Big Duck.
Fenella's horses, I was horses.
Yeah, Fenella was tiny horses, because I think the tiny horses would just overwhelm you.
But they're tiny?
Yeah, but they're horses.
What does that difference does that make?
Journalistic rigor here.
Absolutely.
On
Absolutely, but
on URY,
what's
on
your plan for the rest of the evening? You excited? What are you going to get up to now?
How are you going to celebrate?
I must hang out. I go to party with my teammates tonight. We'll be crazy. Yeah.
Awesome. Very nice. Have the best time. We're going to head back to the main stage very shortly. But thanks for chatting to us. And
thank
congratulations.
You. Thank you.
See you later.
And a prayer for White Rose.
Welcome back to 2024 elections.
Now, have those cocktail sauces hitting, because I know that some of them have sold out already because they're going down well. So go get them from the bar before it's too late. But before that, to ease us into the final few results of the evening, please welcome Jonny, the CEO of the GSA, to the stage.
Hello, Jonny.
Hello. Great to see you.
How are you doing?
Really well, thanks.
Yeah, amazing. So have you been enjoying the night?
Yeah, I think, you know, it's a night of mixed emotions, but it's really good to see so many people here tonight supporting all of the candidates.
It's an amazing turnout, isn't it? And if you were a student, what role would you be running for?
So there's no way when I was a student that I'd had the confidence to run for one of these positions. So kudos to all the candidates. But I think if push came for shove, I would probably go for the community and wellbeing officer.
Oh yeah, how come? Why would you do that one?
So I used to work in the colleges for 10 years, where a big part of my role was looking after a college community and supporting wellbeing, and I absolutely loved it.
Amazing. And have you tried any of our SABS cocktails tonight?
Do you know, I'm more of a beer drinker, but I think if push came to shove, I'd probably try the Anaretto. That sounds quite nice.
Oh, it does, doesn't it? I know, I saw that one. And have you been enjoying this year's campaigns?
Yeah, I mean, there's been such a diverse mix of candidates. I think everyone's really been giving it 100%. It's really interesting to see all of the things that so many of the candidates are really passionate about. So it was just really exciting and enjoyable to witness that.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a really good run this year. And is there anything you want to say to the candidates and everyone in this room?
Just well done to all the candidates. You should all be really proud of yourselves. It's not easy to put yourself forward, so respect.
Amazing. Give it up for Jonny. So, are you guys ready for the final two categories of the night?
No, we can get more than that. Are you guys ready for the final two categories of the night?
I like these guys down the front here
a bit more.
They're great, aren't they?
They're brilliant. Now, first up is our penultimate position, Union Development Officer. It's another new position. A lot of atmosphere at the back for this one. Among other things, the Union Development Officer will be responsible for creating amazing student events on our campus. Let's hear a little more about that.
Union Development Officer. The Union Development Officer leads on events, fundraising, and sustainability. They work with USU's events team to create events and foster a socially responsible student community.
Now, let's hear the candidates. The candidates for Union Development Officer are James Driver,
Jen Andrews,
Charlie Hobson,
Mo Ahmed,
Yaakov Bouani,
and Andrew Preston. Big cheers at the back there. So let's have a look at the graph then.
Here's the first round of voting for UDO.
Will anyone reach the threshold? It is quite close, with Jen in the lead at 823 votes, and Mo closely following with 707. The lowest candidates will be eliminated.
And that is Yaakov and Ron we say goodbye to in the first round, but on to the second round of voting. James, Jen, Mo, Charlie and Andrew all still in this. It's getting tight at the top with Jen and Mo. James, Charlie, and Andrew is going to be the last. So Andrew is going to be eliminated in the second round of voting for going into the third round.
So the votes will be redistributed and we will find out where they go now. It is close running. Jen is just slightly in the lead with 932 votes, but the threshold has still not been reached. So we will eliminate the lowest candidate, which was James.
Down to three as we go to the fourth round of voting. I can't count. And it's Jen in the lead with Mo in second, and Charlie Hobson is unfortunately eliminated in the fourth round of voting. Jen with 1,081 votes, Mo with just over 800 as we go to the final round.
Will the threshold be reached? Who will win this year's Union Development Officer? Let's have a look. It's big anticipation.
Tension.
But the winner
is Jen. Congratulations, Jen. You are the new Union Development Officer.
Come down to the stage.
Thank you so much.
How are you doing? How are you feeling?
I was so stressed about that, so I'm so relieved.
Amazing. And how did you find the whole campaign process?
I've really loved it. I mean, I've met some truly amazing people and some experiences I would never have had otherwise, so yeah.
Oh, this obviously means so much to you, so yeah. Being up on stage. What are you most excited to do in this role?
So much, but I just really, what I've done in Alistair is build community, and so I really want to continue that to the wider university.
Amazing. I saw your campaign, I'm just Jen. Are you just Jen?
I am just Jen, yeah.
You are enough.
Incredible. Well, let's take a little look at your manifesto. Everyone, give it up for Jen.
Woo!
Hi, I'm Jen, and I'm running to be your Union Development Officer. I'm a third year History and Politics student and the current president of Alistair College. I intend to take my current experience as a student leader even further, revolutionising USU's approach to community building with a proposal for ambitious events, all rooted in sustainable practices and a dedication to institutional accountability. First, I intend to revitalise our campus, ensuring that USU events take full advantage of venues which are constantly underutilised. The social provision on Campus East must increase, and more emphasis must be placed on ensuring that campus remains a vibrant place in the evenings. Second, I will ensure that USU fully commits to sustainable practices, being purposefully transparent in all its own actions, whilst also holding the uni accountable. Third and finally, I will develop a more effective way to champion student leaders, lobbying for the funds to construct a more meaningful reward system. For a genuine candidate with the values and vision to prove it, choose Jen.
And now, it's time for our final result of the evening.
Aww.
I know, I've been enjoying this actually.
It's been good. So let's find out who will be running for Community and Wellbeing Officer. It is the hottest contested role with 9 candidates. So let's hear who's running. We've got Danielle Purvis.
Scotty McGuinness.
Freddie Russell.
Nick Show.
Laurie Lee.
Aurora Zhang.
And Lizzie Freitas-Tay-Sharu.
Now, before we find out who your community and wellbeing officer is, let's welcome to the stage Hannah Nimmo to talk about her time as a SAB.
Hi, Hannah.
Hello, Hannah. How are you doing?
Right, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Now, I don't believe this is the first time I've interviewed you, actually.
It's not, no.
Because you obviously made the progress with the first bus thing, and I gave you an interview on URY,
indeed.
Which was brilliant. So this is your third election results night.
Oh, no, that makes me sound really old, doesn't it?
No, not at all in that way. Now, how does it feel to be here tonight?
It feels really strange to be here and not have the stress of running. I'm still stressed about finding out all the results because there's been so many like hot races this year. But it's been really nice to see so many people have been really happy about being elected. And it's nice to not have the pressure on myself as well of running a campaign again.
Now, of course, and for the Community and Wellbeing Officer, and in fact, all of the candidates in the room, what do you have to say to them?
Just a huge well done. There's so many amazing people, and unfortunately, obviously, the way elections go, most of the people who run lose, which is a shame because there's so many talented people who would do amazing jobs as SABs. So it's just a huge well done to everyone because you should all be really proud of yourselves whether you win or lose tonight.
Absolutely, and obviously, big events have happened throughout your year.
Yes. Quite
most obviously, the union merger with the GSA and USU. How has it felt to have gone through that?
It's been really exciting to go through it. It's been a really great time to be a SAB and to go through such a massive change in the time I've been in office. I've absolutely loved sort of working on the merger, sort of shaping the new SAB role, shaping the new union as a whole. It's been a really special time.
And of course, the last 2 years. What have been your best bits, your favourite
really
moments?
That's really hard to answer. I've had so many amazing things.
Put you on the spot.
I guess my two highlights would be the £1 million cost of living support that Pierrick and I were able to secure, because £1 million was like our top goal and we completely surpassed it and we're still going.
Can everyone just give it up for that? £1 million, how incredible is that?
Thank you. And the other one, again, Matthew, you've already addressed it, but Fix First. It was a massive campaign I ran. We sent nearly 7,000 letters to the university and First Boss. And that was bigger than I ever thought it was going to be. So that was just incredible to lead on as an officer as well.
No, absolutely. Thank you so much for your time
thank
tonight.
You so
and
much.
Thank you so much for your time as a SAB as well. Everybody, Hannah Nimmo.
I think one thing that's really incredible is seeing how many students these officers affect. And it's going to be incredible to see the next SABS officers and their impact on the students' lives too. So let's find out the results for the final roll of the evening.
Let's take a look at who's going to make it out of the first round of voting.
The quota is 1,244 votes. Will we reach it this time?
And as we can see, we have Freddie, Aurora, Nick and Laura with comfortable votes. Lizzie slightly behind, Danielle, Scotty and Ron at the bottom, which means we will eliminate Danielle, Scotty and Ron from contention in the first round. And on to the second.
The second round, where Freddie, Aurora, Nick, Laura and Lizzie are running. Is anyone going to reach the threshold this time? It is really close.
It's incredibly close at the top, and Lizzie with 329 votes is falling behind, which means, unfortunately, Lizzie has been eliminated in the second round.
Wow. Let's have another look. What's going to happen next?
Third round of voting, the quota is 1,147 votes, and it's incredibly tight once again, just a few votes in between them.
Freddie is at 617, Aurora 514, Nick at 607, and Laura at 556. So we're going to say goodbye to Aurora.
Which leaves us with three going into the fourth round. We told you the system was pretty difficult and close and intense, and as it's shown to be in the fourth round, that is incredibly
that.
Close. Just
wow.
Trying to do quick maths. 4, 5, 6, 7 votes between Freddie and Nick in the lead, which means we're going to have to unfortunately say goodbye to Laura. And it's incredibly tight going into the fifth round.
Remember, the votes are redistributed. So let's see who is the winner. It's between Freddie and Nick.
The tension's unbearable.
The quota is 748 votes.
Oh, it's incredibly tight.
But Freddie has just won. Congratulations to Freddie Russell.
I don't believe, I don't know what to say.
Oh, amazing. Any emotions? How are you feeling? Can you get any words out?
I'm so happy. I'm so grateful for everybody that's helped me. Isaac for making all the graphics. He's my fucking hero. There's the swear jar.
There's the swear jar.
There you go. Take that one off.
Yeah. Apologies for that.
Sorry. Daisy for doing the TikTok. What a legend. And everybody that has let me yell about stress this week, you are all my heroes. Thank you.
It was so tight watching that. What were you thinking when you were watching the results being elected?
I was so, so nervous. The fact that it came down to single figure votes is something that we never could expect. I want to thank as well all the candidates that ran in my race for making it such a great race, and particularly Nick as well, for being so close to that. He deserves a massive amount of credit. He's run a brilliant, brilliant campaign. And been lovely throughout. So yeah. Honestly, I'm such a rush right now.
Oh bless you. I was going to ask you what you're most excited for. If you can think about that.
I have no idea. Probably the drink that's waiting for me at my table.
Absolutely.
Beyond that, getting to work and making York better.
Incredible.
Brilliant.
Well, give it up for Freddie. Let's take a look at all of Freddie's promises. Then here's his manifesto.
Hi, I'm Freddie, and I want to be the next Community and Wellbeing Officer at USU. Here's what I'd like to achieve in the role. I want to work with different groups to build a welcoming student community on and off campus. At the minute, burnout is one of the biggest issues that students are facing. I want to collaborate with different partners like societies and external groups to put on regular social well-being sessions to give students a break from their busy lives. I also want to foster that same sense of community by working with these external partners in the City of York so students can feel integrated into the place that they study. My second big policy is I want to push to streamline, standardise and improve university support services. At the minute, there's a good breadth of support available, but not all of it works together in the best way. I want to make sure that the support services are as communicative and holistic as possible, and that the support is accessible and open as possible. And finally, I want to fight for students amid the rent crisis. While there are cost of living grants available, these need to be more visible, more open, and matched to the exponential rising costs for students. So if all of that sounds good, then get ready to vote for Freddie.
Thank you, and congratulations to Freddie. What a night!
Everyone, give it up for all the newly elected candidates! What an achievement. We have new SABS officers, and we're all very excited for that.
And I also want to say a big thank you and congratulations to all our wonderful candidates. It's been a truly fantastic campaign season, and we have all of you to thank.
And although we are finished here, we do have an incredible after party. So make sure you get yourself down to Vanbrugh Arms, and there'll be lots of photos and drinks and everything happening. So go on down there, everyone.
Absolutely. And my producer has noted to me that our photographer will be at Vanbrugh Arms taking official election photos. So if you have been successful in your campaign to be a sabbatical officer, make sure you are there. That's where your official election photos will be taken. And of course, there'll be other photos as well. So make sure you make it.
Thank you to everyone who has been here tonight, everyone watching at home. This has been the results election night 2024, and we'll see you guys next year.
Thank you so much for joining us, and good
night.
Thank
you, goodbye.
Welcome back to our final green room. We would like to apologize for any fruity language you heard on the stage, but we're here with our brand new first ever union development officer, Jen Andrews.
Hiya.
So how are you feeling after your victory this evening?
A bit more relaxed. I think the video that is there is just me like gasping into the microphone. So yeah, but so happy.
Lots of excitement.
Yeah.
Very excited. Well, you're just Jen. We know this. We've established this. And clearly the students of the University of York think that York enough for them. So I was wondering, how did you enjoy campaigning? What was your favourite bit of campaigning? How's the week been?
I mean, campaigning's obviously stressful, but I actually have loved it so much. I mean, me painting signs on the floor of our kitchen all week. Maybe my flatmates haven't liked that, and everyone has been so lovely that I've met as well. So it's truly like the experience of a lifetime. When would I ever be doing this?
When was the last time you did painting like that?
Probably primary school. Like,
oh, just like all of your posters have been quite punny because you have I'm Just Jen, but you've got genuine vision. My clipboard's falling away. Genuine values. Like, who came up with all the puns? Was it you?
Well, I can't take credit for all that. So my lovely campaign manager who is there, Harry Wilson, he's the mastermind behind genuine vision and also those I'm Just Jen and I Am Genuff posters.
Oh yeah.
And then Josh Bryce, my friend, we were having a lunch together as a friend group and he said, I'm Just Jen. And I thought, that's
genius.
Golden. That's golden.
We're going to remember that.
Genius. It's all my friends.
Genius.
Oh,
no. I'm joining. So funny.
No, it really is. So what are you most excited to do in your next year in this brand new role?
I said it before, but like building community has been all what I'm all about in Analysta. So I'd really love to do that on a bigger stage. And there's some things that I was talking about in my manifesto, like about the buses and about reviving life on East with an extra YUSU venue. And I really, really want to push to make those things a reality. So yeah.
Awesome. Well, obviously we asked the big questions here on UI. We're
absolutely
very serious journalists. We've got one for you now. If a dog wore shoes, would it be on the back paws or all of them?
All of them.
All
I'd
the
say
paws.
All of them.
You were saying otherwise earlier.
Because that's not legs then. That's their that's
but
their
they're
like
all
hands.
Legs.
But they all touch the ground.
Dogs
different.
Have four legs and shoes are for legs.
Well, shoes are for feet, really, aren't they?
Yeah, shoes aren't for
shoes
legs.
Shoes are for feet. That's what I meant.
They're not feet, they're paws. Yeah, you know?
But wait, we're living in a world where the dogs
listen,
are wearing shoes.
I think this is going to end in a fight or, you know.
With a horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses.
Absolutely. Well, some sort of assault. So we're going to move on to our final game. We've already had a little go with it, but only temporarily. So we'll... I think this is our favourite game.
We like this game.
We play it a lot.
So the premise, it's called... Do you want to do it properly this time?
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
That's foul! So basically, we're going to give you a name of a duck, and you have to tell us if it's a real breed of duck a fake breed of duck. Is it foul? White waterfowl? We think we're clever.
Yeah.
We'll get on to our first one.
Go.
The childish white duck. Is that real or is it fake?
Real.
Absolutely not.
That's a fake duck.
Real, it's a fake.
Right. Damn. Round two. Let's go. The wandering whistling duck.
I have to go for fake now because I went for real fake.
It's a real duck. He be wandering, he be whistling.
Absolutely. That's me.
That's so you.
So me.
Do you want to do another one?
I would like to do another one.
Go for it.
The hard head duck.
Real.
This is correct.
That is a real duck. Well done. We've got.
I wonder how they tested that.
What do you mean, see if it's got a hard head?
Just punched it in the face.
It.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't think that's allowed in the university.
Poor duck. Maybe that's what happens to Longboy.
Maybe. Who knows? Ask Greg James.
Moving swiftly on. The Kinder duck.
Fake.
That is fake. That is not foul.
It is indeed fake.
Congrats.
It's not made of Kinder eggs. The flat-footed duck.
I mean, a lot of ducks are flat-footed.
This is true.
They're all flat-footed.
This is true.
So fake.
This is correct. That was a good bit of logic there. I'll give you that.
I really thought that through. That's my union development officer.
Yeah. You've said that for every single officer.
Because you shouldn't have said that. I would have been so flattered.
What we got? We got the super meat duck.
That has to be fake.
That is fake.
We've got the brown feather beaver tail duck.
Fake.
This is also correct.
Yeah.
What we got? We've got the plump-breasted duck, and that's going to be our final one.
Fake.
It's a fake duck. It's
all
not a real duck.
All of these ducks have been fake.
But
listen,
thank you for chatting to us. Congrats on your brand new role.
Thank you very much.
And we're going to move over to our new community wellbeing officer. If you want to do some musical chairs and swap, we don't have a cut screen. But thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jen. Congratulations.
No time for pleasantries, Freddy.
No
time.
I've got to get
into it. We are ready for Freddy.
Oh, I'm so glad. I didn't think anybody was. I thought you guys still needed preparing, but it turns out no.
We are so ready for Freddy.
Oh, man.
How are you doing?
I'm a whirlwind. I have not processed like anything. It doesn't feel real at all. Nothing does.
You're in the room.
I'm just in a room. It's utterly mental.
Awesome. Has it been you behind your signs all over campus? I don't know if you've got any of your drawn signs back here. I don't think you do.
I should say that as well. So it's a red panda.
Yeah.
But the person behind them is Patrick Brogan. That is the person behind the art.
Because big up yourself, Patrick.
Patrick is an absolute miracle worker. He's my housemate. I have no idea. He did all of that art in one afternoon.
Oh, wow.
It was absolutely unbelievable. Credit to him because I have no artistic skill whatsoever. I said, can you do something visual with it? And he went and did the most beautiful drawings of this red panda I have ever seen in my life.
They've been really cute to see.
Yeah,
I'm
glad. Some people have come up to me and said, I'm voting for you purely because you have a nice animal.
Well, clearly, here
we
are.
Every vote counts.
But you're not an artist, but you are your comedy sock.
I am, yes.
You're a comedian.
Yes, that's sort of...
Tell me a joke, funny man.
You got a joke.
Oh, not this again. This is the default question I get asked. that's my people by trade. Big up to all the people from Comedy Sock. Without them, I probably wouldn't be here today. There they are over there. Bunch of lovely...
Hiding in a corner.
Brilliant people. Aww. Big up to them. Heroes, every single one of them. Mm.
So why community and wellbeing?
Yeah, so I've had a lot of people ask me this, particularly in lieu of me not going for something like activities, which previous Comedy Sock president, Rohan Asher, went for.
The man, the myth, the legend.
The man, the myth, the legend. Community and wellbeing... Wellbeing has been something I've been very open about, very passionate about, my own wellbeing. And I think it's really, really important. I knew I wanted to be a SAB. I just had to find the right way to direct the energy, the right place to put it. And community and wellbeing just felt right. So I went for it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're going to move on to our final game of the evening.
Do you not want
to
watch this
game?
One?
Oh.
Oh, no, that is a very important question.
Script conflicts.
No,
go on.
We always have script conflicts. You should know about this, Fraser.
It's true. I'm a comedian.
You want to know.
How would you get away from a crocodile?
How would I get away from a crocodile?
And that's not the punchline to a joke. I want to know.
Yeah, this is a strange
situation.
You're
in situation. The situation.
Yeah.
Staring him down.
Yeah, I'm
what
in
do
there.
You do?
Right, so first port of call is weapons. Right,
okay.
I'm looking at Fraser.
Okay.
He's arming
what have I got? Right, I'm talking sticks. I'm talking rocks. I'm talking fists, if necessary. Right, then I'm seeing, okay, he's got a big jaw. That might be a weakness. Right, can I pry it open?
Who's got a bigger mouth, though? A crocodile or the president of the
This is true. This is true. In terms of words per minute, I think I might have him beat there. But yeah, in terms of teeth per gum, he's probably got
okay.
Me. But yeah, so I'm taking a physical approach is what I'm trying to say.
Physical.
Okay.
I'm going to try and
he's
beat
choosing
him up.
Violence.
Yeah, I'm going to try and beat him up.
Could you not try and reason with the crocodile?
Yeah, this is. I'm just now realizing this is not great for someone who's just been elected as community and wellbeing officer.
No. I'm going to fight.
Yeah, I'm going to battle
that's
him.
That's proactive.
Yeah,
that's
and listen.
Confident.
The votes are closed.
You're stuck with him.
So deal with it, you
yeah,
know.
Like Joe said, we've got a little game.
Okay,
it's
go for it.
It's called Wrong Answers Only.
Wrong Answers Only.
So
have you played this game before?
I have heard this game played on the radio.
Well, we're back on the radio.
Yes.
So
yeah, my mother plays it often in the car.
So what we want from you is anything but the right answer.
Anything but the right answer.
So are you ready?
I'm ready.
We're gonna go for it.
I'm so ready.
What color is the sky?
Green.
What color is my shirt?
Green.
How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck
green.
Wood?
Green.
How many legs does a spider have?
Green.
Oh, I hate you.
Name a yellow fruit.
Orange.
Oh.
What animal is York's campus famous for?
The swallow.
How many fingers am I holding
green.
Up?
Green.
What college are we in?
Green.
What does it say on my microphone?
Nice person.
And what are you sat on right now?
Green.
I don't even know if that counts, to be honest.
I think it does, and I think if...
It's technically a wrong
answer. Do you
answer,
like green?
Yeah, it's
you've
one of
come
my,
in the full green garb.
It's definitely one of my favourite colours.
You dressed like the alligator?
There. I am slightly.
Was it crocodile?
I did worry I went a bit too sort of stand-up-y with my outfit, but then again, you can't ditch your roots, you know? You've got to stay true to
absolutely
it.
Absolutely not. But you're excited.
I'm so
you're
excited.
Happy. Have you had a Saab cocktail?
Oh, I have. Yes, I have.
Awesome.
Of course, a non-alcoholic one because we are on the radio.
Of course.
But have a good night.
Thank you so much for having me.
And congratulations. Hopefully see you soon
Thanks
in
so
your
much.
New role.
Yes.
Have
yes.
fun.
Hopefully.
Thank
I'll try.
See
I'll
you
try.
Later.
Right. I will know campaigning's over.
So that is it for Election Results Night 2024. Jess, how have you found it so far?
So good.
It's been so good.
I feel great.
But it's all we've got time for, I'm afraid.
Aww.
So I'd just like to thank you for tuning in on YSTV and listening on URY. This has been Election Results Night 2024. Please do keep interacting on Twitter. Hashtag York Student Union Elections.
Is that it? Hashtag York SU
York
Elections.
York SU Elections 2024.
We know.
I've already messed it up. So let's recap the new
you cut
officers.
My line.
I'm sorry.
We spent time. Anyway, congrats to all the winners. You've all worked so hard. We've loved to see you campaigning. Honestly, what is with. Right, let's recap.
Useless. It's a real downgrade from last year.
So for academic officer, you've got Fenella Johnson.
Our new activities officer is Kaitlyn Beattie-Zarb.
Our sports officer re-elected Tanisha Jain.
The new union affairs officer is Lewis Parrey.
For equality and inclusion, we've got Ezreal G.
The brand new role of union development officer is Jen Andrews.
And for community and well-being, the green queen, Freddie Russell.
Absolutely.
Bosh.
So thanks very much for YUSU for organizing this. Thanks to the YUSU bar staff for hosting this fantastic event and to providing some cracking Saab cocktails.
And thank you, obviously, to YSTV, TechSoc, and URY for putting together all this broadcast that you've been watching, I assume.
I assume
so. Or listening
so.
To.
So thanks very much. I've been Joe.
I've been Jess.
And thank you for listening. We will catch you on the flip side.
Whoa. Bye.
Bye.